Hello guys, and welcome to another Dancehall's online lecture. And this lecture we are going to cover the functional classification of proteins. Now in the other lecture we have discussed what amino acids are and what proteins really are. Now today we're going to basically look at the functions of the proteins. And this functional classification, we are going to divide the functions of proteins into different classes. Now in doing so, we're going to look at the basic classifications. Now we have some basic classifications of protein that we would like to cover here. Now, the basic classifications are, we have a protein that we call a structural proteins. Now, a structural proteins are those proteins, as the name implies, that will function to give rigidity and structural support to the cell, like the proteins that you are going to have on your cell walls. They're all going to be structural proteins, since they're going to give you structural supports in order to be able to resist physical interactions. Now the second type of protein that we have in terms of functions is what we call the sensory proteins. Now as the name implies, the sensory proteins are proteins that will work in the transduction of information between inside and outside of the cell. Even information or a message supposed to get out of the cell for reaction to happen, these are the proteins that will make that transfer of that information. And it is quite a very important protein, since the whole process that happens in our cells are basically or partly or fully depend on signaling, for signal to happen before any reaction can be taken by the cells. Now, we also have proteins that we call regulatory proteins. These are quite very important proteins. They regulate the cell in many processes, like during transcription, during translation, during replications. These are the proteins that will regulate to correct some errors to make sure when the genes are going to be switched off and when they are going to be switched on. So all those roles are controlled and carried out by these regulatory proteins. So regulatory proteins are quite important. Without these proteins, we're going to be seeing so many syndromes, so many diseases and infections in our bodies or in our systems. So because of these regulatory proteins, that they function largely during processes, important processes for that matter, like transcription and translation. Now, we also have what you call locomotory proteins, and these are the proteins that will help the organisms to be able to move, or for the cells to be able to move, like the proteins that are found in the flagella of organisms. You can see it is all proteins, and these proteins will help during the movement. We also have the actin and then the myosin filaments in the extracellular matrix, and they are all important and vital to support the movement of organisms. The final and the last one that we're going to discuss today are the transport proteins. Now, these transport proteins are very important. I'm going to give an example of cell membrane here. Now, lipid bilayer. Now, this cell membrane, we know this is the inside of the cell. And we have the extracellular matrix here, that is the outside of the cell. Here also is outside of the cell. Now, this inside and outside of the cell, for materials to be able to exchange or to move from inside here to outside here or to the other side, there has to be some proteins that normally different classes can be here, and some of them can be here. So this protein would be responsible to transport substances from outside here to inside of the cell here, so that substance can move from outside to inside of the cell, and they can also move from inside of the cell to outside of the cell. You call them transport proteins. So this is what we're going to discuss today. I hope you are really going to enjoy this lecture. Any question that you might have or doubt, feel free to contact me via this YouTube channel. I shall get back to you, and until then, enjoy the video.